Hello guys, and welcome back to a new video here at Architects3DP. Today we're going to review a really cool set of devices provided by Basswood. As you may have seen recognized from the intro, they are the TWOTREES TS2 10 watts laser engraver, their silent air pump, and their honeycomb cutting table. Basswood not only provided us with the products for free, but also got you guys huge discount codes that you will find right here, as well as down in the description. When you go to the product page in Basswood, you can just click on buy now, and when you insert the coupon code right here and apply it, you will immediately see your huge discount applied. So guys, don't wait and go get yours before the promotion expires on October 31st. Okay, so the three products came inside different boxes. To start, here we have two small boxes that, as you can see, come from TWOTREES, and I'm going to put them on one side because we have more guys. This big and heavy box has the TWOTREES TS2 10 watts laser engraver inside, and as you can check, it has traveled a little bit from the TWOTREES factory to here. I will start with the unboxing of the smaller packages, and then I will go for the beast, the TWOTREES TS2 10 watts laser engraver and cutter. But that's gonna be after I introduce you our great channel sponsor that is no other than PCBWay. PCBWay is your website to get your PCB prototypes the easy way. Thanks to PCBWay, you can get your own prototypes made in a very short time for a very competitive price. By the way, I strongly recommend you to enter their 5th PCB design contest right now if you haven't yet, before the deadline that will be on December 31st. You can choose in between next generation hardware, earth-friendly project, or free theme. Take this opportunity to share your knowledge and have the possibility to earn the amazing prizes that you can see on screen. Find more information through the link in the description or at PCBWay.com. Alright, so back to the unboxing. Here I have the smallest box. Inside we have some protective foam, and just underneath we'll find a very cool case together with a red accessory and the power supply. Those components are meant to complement the silent air compressor assist from TWOTREES that I'm going to leave right here. Inside the case, we also find some more red accessories, some more bolts and keys, cable adapters, and the pipe itself. Having a look at these cable adapters, we can see that we'll use them to connect from this side this thicker pipe that will plug into the pump itself, and on the other end, the pipe that will go all the way to the laser nozzle. To make this work, I guess we'll only need to plug in the power cord right here on the front, plug into the network, and we're ready to make our first test. As you can probably hear, it is working very silently. The air pressure is not impressive, but is able to blow away this plastic as you can see here. You can regulate the power through this little knob, which is also really cool. Finally, once we are done using it, we can disconnect the cable and put the cap back in place. And I'm gonna do that to continue with the unboxing of the other small box that I have right here, and I don't know if it is a laser device or a pizza. When we open it, the first we can find is a set of magnets with 3M adhesive at the back. And after removing the protective foam on top, here we can already see a honeycomb bed and a metallic sheet that we'll use to protect our table surface. After removing all the protective plastic that took me a while, here we have, guys, as you can see, our cutting bed that will go on top of the metallic sheet just like that. The honeycomb bed is gonna make a huge difference in our laser cuts, getting a very clean surface at the bottom. If you remember from the previous laser machines we have revealed, when we cut wood or any other material, the bottom surface gets very dirty, as you can see for example in this foam stand that we cut with the X-Tool D1 Pro. And that happens because the fumes have nowhere to go here at the bottom. With the help of the air pump and the honeycomb bed, this is not going to happen again. Okay guys, so these accessories are really cool, but don't you want to go for the TWOTREES TS2 laser engraver? Because I do, and that's what I'm gonna do now. So I have opened the care book, and I'm going to take out the cool box that is inside. To my surprise, there were 3 boxes instead of 1, the last one having several damages from the shipping. I hope everything inside is okay. Here I have all 3 boxes, and I'm going to start opening them here from the back. In the first one, as you can see, we can find some papers, example materials, tools, accessories, the power cord, protective goggles, a brush, USB cable, the 10 watt laser head itself, more accessories, and at the very bottom what looks like the Y-axis motor attached to a structure profile. In the next box we have the instructions, some cable chains, the power supply, and what looks like the front of the machine, where the motherboard is placed and all the connections are done. Finally, in the third box we can find more structural profiles.
This might be one of the sides, this the other side, and finally the X-axis gantry.
Okay guys, so everything is out of the boxes. I don't know why TWOTREES used 3 boxes instead of 1, but anyways, it has been a good unboxing experience overall. Now let's have a closer look at every component we just unboxed before starting with the build.
Okay, so here we have the back structure of the laser. Here, one of the sides, that as you can see has a cool tensioner mechanism here at the middle, then the other side with the same system, the X-axis of the laser, and finally here we have the front structure of the printer, that as you can see comes with every cable plugged to the motherboard. We also unboxed the 10-watt laser head, a cool little brush, and the power cord extension that will plug into the power supply right here. Then a USB-A to USB-B cable, and the same green protective goggles that we found in the first laser engraver we unboxed from TWOTREES. Then we have a bag with very properly tagged bolts, some accessories, this one that looks like the cover for the laser head. Yes, as you can see, it goes right here. Next, we find some tools, zip ties, connectors, and the SD card. Then a motor with a very cool red pulley installed, and we finally go to the materials bag. As you can see, was played where the impact on the box happened. This 2mm cardboard is so destroyed as you can see, and probably we won't be able to use it for our tests. We also have some sandpaper, I don't know why, then a couple metallic tags, and a piece of black acrylic that we'll be able to cut with our laser.
Okay guys, so that was it. I'm finally going to start with the assembly of the machine, because I already want to see how it works. The quality is really high from what I've been able to see so far, and I guess this laser will work as a charm.
To start, we'll need the front, back, and left side of the laser that will be placed just like that. We'll pass the belt through the pulley, and we'll fit it in place just like so. Once done, we'll insert the 2 bolts that hold it in place and tighten them a little bit using the Allen key. Now at the front, the profile will go just like that, attached with 1 bolt that we'll put right here. As you can see, one of the sides of the Y-axis is already moving. Next step will be to install these 2 bolts right here on the front, attaching the pulley to the frame. We can tighten them all the way through. And now we're going to tighten all the bolts we installed before as well. Next step will be to turn the laser upside down, since we're going to tighten the belt tensioner mechanism that we have at the bottom. As you can see, there is enough tension on the belt, so we're going to continue with the build. We'll continue now from the right hand side, where we'll do the same we did in the left hand side, and I'm going to pass very quickly. Alright guys, so it seems like the main structure of the laser is completely built. Now I'm going to align the Y-axis carries to one of the ends, and tighten the couplings here at the back on both sides of the Y-axis motor. Once done, as you can see, both sides work together, since the belts are synchronized. Next step will be to install the X-axis bridge here on top, for what we'll need the 2 M5x40mm bolts, as well as an M4x16 and an M5x20. We'll install them right here, so starting from the right hand side, the M5x20 goes on the outside, just like that, and the M4x16 goes here inside. Here we go. Now on the left hand side, we'll insert the M5x40s from the top, and we'll tighten them all the way through.
We have the structure of the laser engraver complete, guys. The last step will be to install the laser head in place, and I guess make all the cable connections and attach every cable chain in place, and we will be ready to go.
So the laser head will go right here. We'll slide it from top, and we'll attach it with the 4 M3x6mm bolts. For that, we'll need to move the head down just like that, so we'll be able to reach the holes that are quite tricky. Once done, we'll continue with the 2 at the bottom, and finally tighten all 4 all the way through. The protector we saw before will go right here at the bottom, holded by these 2 thumb screws. We'll move it up, so the probe can touch the bottom surface before the acrylic when it makes the autofocus. Next, we're going to start connecting all the cable chains in place, for which I'm going to remove the protective wraps. The first connection we're going to make is the X-axis cable chain, and to make all the connections, we'll use the M3x6mm bolts. The first connection is going to be here in the laser carry, where we'll insert these 3 bolts. Next, on the other end, we'll attach this part with 2 bolts. Now we'll insert this accessory here at the bottom that will hold the cable chain in place, and we're going to continue attaching cable chains. First, this end right here for the Y-axis. And then, at the front of the printer, after unwrapping this end stop device and installing it in place just like that, we'll install the last end of the cable chain. Here we go. Now we're going to mount the X-axis motor in place just like that. These red pulleys are very cool, by the way. And once done, we'll insert the timing belt in place just like that. At the other end, we'll now insert the tensioner thumbscrew, and we'll use it to tighten the belt so it has enough tension to work properly. I think that's more than enough.
The structure is now complete and all the accessories are installed. The last thing we'll need to do is gonna be to connect all the cable, and that's exactly what I'm gonna do right now.
We'll start with the autofocus motor, as well as connecting the cables coming from the module. Here we go. The only end left is going to be the air pipe that we'll connect later on. Now on the side, we'll connect the X-axis sensor and motor as you can see here. In the back of the laser, we'll plug in the Y-axis motor, and here, next to the motherboard, we'll connect the Y-axis end stop just like that. As you can see guys, here we have our TWOTREES TS2 Laser Engraver completely built. The cable chains make the real difference with all the laser engravers we rebuilt. I really think every machine should include them. Next, I'm going to install the connections for the air pump right here at the laser nozzle. It goes just like that.
Alright guys, so the laser itself is completely assembled. What we're gonna do now is to install all the accessories we unboxed at the beginning of the video before making the first tests.
So starting with the honeycomb, we'll install the protective sheet at the bottom and the honeycomb mesh on top just like that. As you can see, we won't be able to use the provided materials because of the shipping issues. So I'm going to pick up the one that came with the other TWOTREES laser engraver and we used with all our laser machines so far. I'm going to place it right here, so we can still use this empty space we have left. And at this point, we only need to connect the last accessory, the air pump we unboxed before. This time, the air pipe is already installed in the TS2 laser, so we'll pick up the pipe adapter and we'll connect it to both the pipe coming from the machine and the air pump just like that. We'll connect the power from the front as well, and we'll be ready to go. After connecting the cables for the laser engraver, you'll need to rotate this red button to turn on the machine. As you can probably hear, the fans on the laser head started spinning.
What means that we have a fully functional TWOTREES TS2 10 watts laser engraver and cutter going on, guys. As always, we have prepared a really cool set of cool shots of the laser machine and its accessories working that I hope you will enjoy. As you have seen guys, such a cool set of devices, isn't it? Also, as you may have seen in the cool shots, the engraving work that is going on is looking just fantastic. We'll have a look at it in a couple of minutes, once it's done.
And as you can see, the machine just finished and the result is just incredible. I used dynamic power for the laser, setting the minimum power to 0 and the max to 5%, and check out this amazing result. As you can see, you can differentiate the different tones of the drawing, and the resolution is just incredible. But will this laser cut through? That's something that we're gonna test right now. And as you can see, the 10 watt laser is able to cut through this thin wood very fast with a single pass. The cut, as you can see, is very clean, despite the wood was already damaged from previous tests.
Alright guys, so the video is getting so long and we have no more time to keep talking about this incredible machine. But as you have been able to see, overall the TWOTREES TS2 10 watts laser engraver and cutter is an incredibly capable machine, as well as its accessories that will complement your experience. If you're interested in more tests with this machine or any other laser we unbox in the channel, please leave a lot of comments down below and we'll make a video comparing all of them. To finish, please make sure you are subscribed to the channel, consider supporting my work on Patreon as all these amazing people does, and as always, see you in the next video.